Today we're going to talk about interfacing a fire alarm system to an elevator. Here we have a nice elevator lobby with a smoke detector used for elevator recall. And somewhere there's a machine room that'll have control modules or relays to activate elevator recall.
First, we'll discuss why a fire alarm and elevator systems are interfaced and what are the codes that govern that. NFPA 72, Chapter 21, is what governs the fire alarm system. It states that smoke detectors in the elevator lobbies, the hoistway, the machine room, all must activate what's called a Phase 1 recall for the elevator, and that the smoke detectors in the lobbies must be within 21 feet of the center of the elevator door. Smoke detectors don't need to be installed in the hoistway unless there is smoke relief or if the hoistway has sprinklers. In some circumstances, a water flow switch for the elevator pit may also initiate elevator recall. During the design phase, the elevator will have a designated and an alternate level recall. And what it says is that all associated fire alarm devices will recall the elevator to the designated level unless the source of the fire is on the designated level, in which case, then it'll recall it to the alternate level. Elevator shutdown occurs when either the machine room or the hoistway has sprinklers. In that case, heat detectors are installed within 24 inches of the sprinkler head, and the fire alarm will be programmed to do a shunt trip to kill the power before water flows. In the elevator, there'll be a visual indicator that will light up, letting first responders know that Phase 1 recall has been activated. That indicator will be illuminated steady unless the source of the alarm is in the hoistway of the machine room, in which case it'll be intermittent or blink. The image at the bottom shows the visual indicator circled in yellow that will light up, and next to it is the fire department override key. Now what we can do is apply this to a building. We've got a four-story building with an elevator shaft and machine room. We're going to put a smoke detector in each elevator lobby and one in the machine room. And what you're going to need to do is to coordinate with the elevator contractor to determine which is the main and alternate landings. Once you've determined that, you can figure out where you want to send the elevator car. Green is for primary recall or designated level, and blue is for the alternate level. So what will happen is anything on the first floor is going to send it up to the alternate landing. After you've done that, you can create a matrix showing which detectors are going to trigger which outputs on the fire alarm system. We've added fire alarm control modules at the elevator controller. And lastly, some controllers don't need a separate input for recall from a device that's located in the machine room. That's something you'll coordinate with the elevator contractor. If we move our machine room to the top of the hoistway, what that does, it changes the matrix so that the machine room detector activates primary recall instead of alternate recall now. If we move the machine room into the basement, then that machine room smoke detector will still activate primary recall. What if instead of a basement, the building has a ground floor and a first floor level, both of which have grade exits on them? You may need to get with the elevator contractor now and determine which is going to be the main level and which is going to be the alternate level. And in this case, the main is determined to be the ground floor. Once the main and alternate levels are understood, then you can identify where you're sending the elevator based on the source of the fire, and finally create your matrix showing which detectors will trigger which modules on the fire alarm. We'll put our building back to the way it was and add some more variables you may run into, such as a sprinkler in the machine room. If you have that, you need a heat detector within 24 inches of that sprinkler head. Adding that heat detector to the control matrix, and you'll see that we also added a control module for shunt trip. That heat detector is going to activate that shunt trip, the fire hat, and the alternate recall. And you can program a delay to give the elevator time to recall before the shunt trip occurs. Moving the machine room to the top of the hoistway, does not change the fire hat or shunt trip programming, but it does change the recall to the primary. Now we will add some more complexity by adding some devices in the hoistway, such as a smoke hatch. If you have that, then you also need to add a smoke detector, and that smoke detector needs to be programmed to trigger an output module. So here's your new matrix. We're showing the smoke hatch, and that smoke detector will open the hatch, do the fire hat, and do the primary recall. The last complexity we'll add to this elevator is to sprinkle the elevator pit. There's a sprinkler head, and if you have that, now you have to add a heat detector within 24 inches. Programming that heat detector will do the shunt trip, the fire hat, and the primary recall. There may be circumstances where the heat detector will activate alternate recall instead.